The breaking news is in the investigation of the El Faro disaster. We now have the first indications of what was said on the bridge of the cargo ship before it sank in Hurricane Joaquin last year.
Government investigators have recovered about 26 hours of information from the voyage data recorder, which was pulled from the ocean floor off the Bahamas. The black box that was located in April near the wreckage, 3 miles below the surface, was recovered earlier this month. The people who are especially anxious for the information are the families of the 33 crew members who died. Channel 4's Francesca Amaker is joining us live now with a statement just released by the National Transportation Safety Board. Francesca.
Well, it was right here at the Seafarers International Union where those families were gathered last year trying to get that critical information. And today we're finding out even more critical information. You'll find that in the information that was released today that the captain actually called for help an hour before the ship sank, and he called an hour before the ship sank, but an hour after they realized the ship was actually in trouble. Now, let's go ahead and show you the video that we have of that ship. According to the National Transportation Safety Board, those 26 hours of recording reveal quite a bit. This includes the events leading up to the loss of the ship, and you can hear the crew discussing what's going on, and although they were saying it's difficult to hear. Now, the recording actually began around 5:30 a.m. September 30th, 2015, about 8 hours after the ship departed from Jacksonville, and the bridge audio from the morning of October 1st captured the master and crew discussing their actions regarding the flooding and the vessel's list. Now, let's go ahead and show you the timeline that we were provided by this press release. The ship loses power and propulsion at 6:13 a.m. At 7:10, Captain Davidson calls shoreside personnel and tells them to notify them of the criticalness of the situation of the ship. And at 7:15, the U.S. Coast Guard received a stress alert from the El Faro, and around 7:30 a.m. on October 1st, the captain ordered all on board to abandon ship by sounding the alarm. Now, right now, there are plenty of officials trying to get their hands on this VDR. It's, like we said, the audio for the VDR is very difficult to hear, so this could take some time. It could take months. It could take years until that audio is actually released to us. Again, this is 26 hours of what happened. And again, coming up at 6 o'clock, I speak with a lawyer who is actually representing one of the families for the El Faro. He tells me why he feels like negligence is definitely the case here and why he feels that there was a critical hour that was missed. That's coming up at 6. For now, live from Francesca Amaker, Channel 4, the local station.